Hello everyone, happy Sunday. Welcome back to another episode of Geering Up Live. So thank you so much for joining us on this beautiful spring day. It's actually snowing where I am, but it is spring regardless. And do you know what reminds me of spring? Number one thing, probably rainbows, because there's a lot of rain, and then after rain, there's always a beautiful rainbow, right? However, today we're not going to be talking about these rainbows that come from the sky. However, we're going to be making our own rainbows at home. And in fact, it's going to be a permanent rainbow. So it's not going to go away after some time after the rain, but we're going to be able to keep it forever. And we're going to be able to make this with nail polish, water, and black paper. So stay tuned in order to find out how to do that and the science behind it. Okay, now before we get started on our experiment, let me explain where colors actually come from. So color and how we perceive color are topics that have been studied for centuries, really, but scientists have reached a conclusion that the color of an object that we see is due to the way that these objects interact with light and reflect that light back into our eyeballs. So the color of an object, you may have heard, actually is not the color of the object itself. Rather, it's the color in that the light shines upon it and that object reflects, and then it's transmitted to our eyes. So the color that we see is really the color that an object reflects. So as you can see on the screen over here, right on top of my head, there is something called a visible light spectrum, which is basically just showing all of the different colors of light that we can see with our eyeballs. So it consists of a range of different frequencies, and frequencies are kind of like categories of specific colors. You can think of it that way if you want to simplify it. And the visible spectrum is light that has different wavelengths, and wavelengths just means how long a light is, a particular color of light is, rather. So a wavelength that's high means that that wave that the color actually consists of is long. So we got the visible light spectrum here, and it ranges from wavelengths of 400 nanometers to 700 nanometers. And you've probably heard of meters before. Meters, for example, you can say you're like 1.5 meters tall, whatever. But meters in this case is not just meters, it's nanometers. Nano always means very tiny. So nanometers is a very, very, very small distance, whereas a meter is quite large. It's about this big. A nanometer is tiny. So the visible light spectrum, if we looked at the individual waves that make up these colors, we would see that it ranges from 700 nanometers to 400 nanometers. And you can see that it's written just on this image right over here. And what happens is you're probably wondering, what about materials that are transparent? Because on this spectrum right over here, we don't really see anything that's clear, and clear isn't really a color. So a lot of things are clear as well. We got things like air, we got water, we got glasses, for example. So let's explain what's happening there with these transparent or clear materials. So with clear materials, when the light encounters that material, almost all of it passes directly through it. For example, glass is transparent to every single color of visible light. And the color of a transparent object depends on the color of light that it transmits. So if green light passes through a transparent object, the emerging light is green. And similarly, if red light passes through a transparent object, the emerging light is red. So now that we've gotten a little bit of an intro to color, let's begin our experiment. And if some of the things I just said doesn't make sense, don't worry, we'll go over it and clarify that a little bit at the end. So the materials that you are going to need for today's stream is black paper. I have some right over here. It's just like construction paper that you can really find at any crafts store. You're going to need some clear nail polish. You're going to need water, a bowl, or a paper, and in addition, you're going to need a paper towel. Instead of that bowl, you can actually use a tray. So, depending on how you like it. Before we do our demo, of course we need to do our safety check to ensure that we are following scientific safety practices even when we're doing things at home. So be sure not to eat or drink any of the materials in this activity. We're going to have water in this activity that we're going to mix with clear nail polish. It's quite obvious that you should not drink this, but it is worth saying again. Also, nail polish does have some fumes that can bother people, so you don't want to do it in a small stuffy room. Go ahead and open up your window or do it in a really big well-ventilated room. You don't want to get dizzy because of the fumes. We want to stay healthy while we do this demo, of course. So let's get right into it. So I'm going to show you my setup here. I have all of the materials laid out. I have a plate that I've put a paper towel on. That's your first step right over there. And just set that to the side for a moment. Right over there. We still want it available. Next, I have a tray here, and I have my black paper. I cut my black paper so that it perfectly fits on my tray. Now, this demo needs to be done fairly quickly in order to be done properly. So what's going to happen here is, let me just remove this bar so that you guys won't be annoyed by it. There we go. Okay, so we got our tray here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour some water in it really carefully. I just got some water in this flask right over here. Regular water, just lukewarm temperature, nothing special. And I'm going to pour it in the tray, so that is about half an inch. I'm covering all of the tray. So now that I got my water in here, the next part of this experiment has to be done fairly quickly. I'm going to explain it before I do it, though. So I have my black piece of paper that I've cut to fit perfectly in the tray, and I'm going to go ahead and soak it. And then once it's soaked, I'm going to bring it up so that it's floating on the surface of the water or near floating. It doesn't have to be perfect. After it is nice and soaked and it is floating on the surface, I'm going to get my clear nail polish, and I am just going to pour a couple drops in there. So it's not too much. It's basically just eyeballed. Nothing too important about how much you do it, but I'm just going to pour it so that it gets on the surface of the water. Afterwards, you're going to let that clear nail polish, it's going to spread on the surface of the water. You're going to count down to about 5 seconds, not too long, and then you're going to quickly grab the piece of paper and put it on your paper towel so that it can dry. Now let's go ahead and do that. Remember that this has to be done quickly. We're going to go ahead and already have our nail polish bottle opened so that we can quickly perform this. So we get our paper, we dip it in here, we soak it so that all of our paper is nice and soaked with that water there. Like that. Might have to put a little bit more water even just to cover it up. Now we're going to lift up our piece of paper so that it is near the surface of this water and it's basically just floating rather than completely submerged. Like that, we're going to get our clear nail polish in just a couple drops. Not too much. That should be good. And you might be able to see this ring that's forming right over here. I'll bring it up closer to the camera here. But there is a little bit of a rainbow pattern that's forming. It's definitely harder to see on camera, but now what we're going to do is we're going to try to lift that black piece of paper carefully, but such that it gets the rainbow like this. There we go. And then we're going to place that right on top of our paper plate or paper towel. Just go ahead and screw the top of your nail polish on again, just so the fumes are less intense. Now I'm going to move this tray to the side for one moment and show you guys our creation. So here it is. I'm going to try to show you the rainbow pattern that's forming. You definitely need some light in order to see it, that it is reflecting light in a way that's kind of like a permanent rainbow. If you've ever been driving and you see on the ground, maybe there's a little bit of a rainbow forming, especially at gas stations. A lot of the time when that gasoline spills on the floor a little bit, it forms this rainbow pattern that's similar to what we formed. Hopefully you can see that. You can see that right over here, that there are colors. And we've created our own permanent rainbow. Now you're going to have to let this dry. It does take maybe an hour or two. You can put it in the sun in order for it to be faster, but since I don't want to make you guys watch that for an hour straight, I prepared one right before this stream so that you can see what happens once it dries. So this is one that I made just this morning. And you can see, it's much easier to see in real life, that's why I really encourage you guys to do this at home, but you can see that there's a rainbow forming on this black piece of paper. And it's much more beautiful in person. It has almost this sparkly, kind of iridescent look to it. And you can see the colors that are forming, especially when we kind of shake it like this and the light hits it at different angles. So that's our demo for today. That is the permanent rainbow that we managed to create just at home. But you might be wondering how, why is there those colors forming on that black piece of paper when we put clear nail polish on it? So let me explain that and the science behind it. So you can see here's just a photo of an experiment that somebody else did. Just with the lighting, you can probably see that rainbow better, but you get the exact same effect if you look at it in person. Just right now with what I created here. Even if you are to shine, let me get my phone and put my flashlight on my phone. If you are to shine light in certain ways, you can see the rainbow. But exact same experiment that we are observing right over here. But let's explore what just happened. So the colors that appear from the nail polish are actually different colors because the light is traveling different distances when it is entering that really thin film of the clear nail polish. And the center of the film, when we dropped the nail polish, is going to be the thickest, and the film gets thinner and thinner as it gets further away from the middle of where we dropped that nail polish in the experiment. And the reason for this is simply because of the way that we applied it. Nail polish dries in layers, much how paint dries on paper. So for a color to appear multiple times, like how we see over here, there's many colors appearing multiple times, there has to be integer multiples of half of the wavelength. And as we said earlier, we know that the visible spectrum, the rainbow of light that we see, has wavelengths that are ranging from 400 to 700 nanometers. And light travels differently through the nail polish than it does through air. So that when the nail polish dries, it doesn't actually have a uniform distribution of thickness. And when light slows down when it reaches the polish, it travels at a slower speed, reflects off the bottom, and then comes out. And as the light travels through the polish, the waves interfere with each other. And this interference pattern emerges, resulting in a different wavelength forming, and consequently different colors just like this. So to simply put, thin films like our nail polish can reflect light in really special ways because they're only a few hundred nanometers thick, and that's the same size range as visible light. So there's other surfaces that can do this. It's not just nail polish that is thin enough in order to reflect light in the visible spectrum. You can see this with bubbles. You can see this with oily surfaces as well. So if you've ever been in a shower before and you've seen a bubble form, and once that bubble gets bigger and bigger and bigger, and eventually it's thin enough, as it gets bigger, it gets thinner, you're gonna see some rainbows form on that bubble. And the reason why rainbows are forming on that bubble is because, again, it is thin enough to reflect the wavelengths of light in the visible spectrum. And for that reason, we see these rainbows when we get these big, big bubbles. So let's talk about other places where we might see these rainbows. Like, why is this important? When are we ever going to need to create a permanent rainbow in real life? Engineers don't do that, right? But it actually reveals a lot about a more important science. So it reveals a lot about something called thin films. And thin films are really special because they can be applied in layers and light can travel through them easily because they're only a few nanometers thick. And thin films can be used in technological senses too. So there's something called nanotechnology. I remember how we talked about how nanometers are like meters, but much, much, much smaller. It's a much smaller distance. So nanotechnology is also technology that deals with things on a very small scale. So nanotechnology, basically very tiny technology. So nanotechnology basically takes advantage of the way that things behave differently at the nano scale, that really small scale, in order to make new products. So for example, we have scientists who are making things like thin film batteries. things like solar panels with these tiny little nano panels and electronic displays even. So thin films are not only useful due to their size though, but also because they can help with the environment. So for instance, we have these thin film solar panels that scientists have been working on, and they're made of these solar cells that have light absorbing layers about 350 times smaller than the regular solar panels that we see. And they have the exact same features as our experiment that we saw today. So solar panels are the newest leading source of renewable energy in our homes too, so this is really important. While where our demo may not be seen in the scientific world, really, the applications and the science behind it certainly is with these nano solar panels that they're making. So that's basically it for new content for this stream, but as always, in order to reinforce our learning, we need to be able to summarize everything that we learned quickly after. Be sure to do that in your own studying at home as well. Be sure to summarize, for example, at the end of your study session, think to yourself, okay, what have I learned in this study session today before you go ahead and close that book up? It's exactly what we're going to do right now. So the number one thing that we learned is that firstly, the color of an object is not actually the color within the object necessarily, but rather it's the color that that object reflects back and goes into your eyeballs. Second, we learned that thin films include things such as our clear nail polish, and these thin films can reflect light in special ways because they're only a few nanometers thick, which is just enough in order to reflect light in the visible spectrum so that we can see colors like that. And number three, we learned that solar panels help save our environment because they renew energy and don't release dangerous emissions, and we can make these solar panels using nanotechnology, using thin films, which is the exact science that we learned in today's demo. So I really hope that you guys enjoyed today's stream. I want to thank all of you guys for tuning in to Geering Up Live. We do have, or I have, episodes every single Sunday at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. So be sure to tune in next Sunday at 10 a.m. And I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your weekend and have a great week. Bye, everyone.